The views and opinions of this broadcast do not reflect the views and opinions of Armed Media, UNU Productions and its affiliates. Enjoy the show. Tax the rich, feed the poor,
welcome to Pod Talk, everybody. I'm Jim Bell.
And I'm Paul Daniels. And we have a special guest tonight.
I'm Donald Wisman. I'm back.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
It's good to be back, man. I enjoy doing these shows with you guys. And I'm thinking about getting Jimmy to start me up my own show again. I'm really thinking, seriously, I'm doing that.
You really should, Donald. You really add a lot to the station.
I've got a good name, too. Me and Jimmy was talking about it. I wanted to be called Born Free.
Born Free?
Born Free. Don't that sound cool?
Oh, you changed it from Live to Die?
No, it sounds like a fucking...
Live Free, Die Free.
Well, Born Free, Die Free. I just think Born Free is a good name for a show. You don't like that, Paul?
No, I don't.
Well, you got to come up with... Well, help me find a name, man, if you don't like that.
I changed it, and I put it in the lineup and everything.
Well, when I start my new show, I mean, I got to come up with something good, and I want you guys' help. I really do.
All right. We'll think about it.
Well, you guys, can I start this off tonight? There's something I want to talk about. I'll start this subject, and I want to hear what you guys think about this. And you guys have probably already heard about this. That little 5-year-old boy out in Wilson, North Carolina, his name was Cannon. I can't pronounce his last name. But I just now read the story this morning, you guys. I cried this morning reading that story. Where the fuck is the outrage for little Cannon? When George Floyd got killed, this whole fucking country, they was burning down cities, and they still are. This fucking guy killed that little kid on a bike. The little 5-year-old kid shot him in the head for no fucking reason. Where's the backlash? Where's the outrage? Why ain't we out here protesting like they did for George Floyd?
Well, because we don't do that shit. It's
right. We know how to act in public.
Well, but I mean, I'm not talking about looting and burning. I'm just talking about getting out here and, hey, this was wrong. I mean, the Black Lives Matter have been out here writing their big slogans all over these streets and stuff. I mean, this is awful, you guys. When a little white kid gets killed, nothing's mentioned. The news just basically swept it under the rug. Nothing's mentioned.
Yeah, up here, the only channel local channel that covered it was the Spanish channel.
Wow. I think it was, that Merriweather guy. He even bought a big gold casket for George Floyd, right?
Yeah.
And we all know it was wrong. I mean, that cop, if he did George Floyd like that, it was wrong. But they acted the wrong way. But this little kid, I mean, he was a baby, you guys, a freaking baby. And that guy was a monster.
5 years old?
5-year-old little boy. And he was just sitting out on his bike.
You know that the guy that killed the kid had had dinner with the father a few days before.
Oh, yes, really? Yes. You know what's going to happen, though? He'll plead insanity or something just because he's black. Now, guys, I'm not a racist. I know you guys aren't either. but the guy, I guarantee you, with all this stuff going on with you know how the country's all racial divided right now, this guy will get special treatment because he's black. I guarantee it, man.
I don't know.
You don't think he will, Paul?
No, not on this one.
And you guys, I'm not talking about
for first degree murder, premeditated.
You know what? The death penalty is too easy for him. I'm like Lethal Injection. That's too easy, Paul. It's too easy, Jimmy.
Well, I've been to jail, and Jimmy has too. And they don't take kindly to people that hurt children.
Right.
Well, I want to see him hung up on a fucking pole, right? Put a news camera on him 24 hours a day. Just give him enough water just to survive. And let the fucking world watch this guy suffer up there. Just let him, or bring him from town to town in a cage. And let us all spit on him. Let everybody spit on this monster, man.
Why don't you just let the family in the room with him?
I mean, like I said, putting him to sleep is too easy for this guy. It's too easy, you guys.
Well,
Lethal Injection.
Yeah, but North Carolina might have different modes. It might not just be lethal injection.
Even if they, I mean, like, I don't know if you guys remember Gary Gilmore, you know, shot through the heart. They shot him.
Yeah, well, he asked for it, a shooting squad.
Yes.
I watched it.
That was a good movie. That was a good.
I watched The Execution.
You
remember? It was on TV.
You guys
televised it.
What? That was in the '70s, though, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Man, they made movies from that. There was like two movies made on them.
The Executioner's song.
That was a good movie.
That was with Tommy Lee Jones.
Tommy Lee Jones, yes. But they made a new one. I forget the name of it, though. I don't remember the name, but it was a good movie too. And I think that's too easy, though. Getting shot. I mean, and Lethal Injection. Maybe gas. Gas is probably a bad way to go. I don't think they do that. Yeah, electric chair, but do they still do that? I know Ohio stopped
that.
They
did in Mass.
Yeah, but Mass doesn't have the death penalty anymore.
Yeah, they don't execute, but they do have an electric chair.
Well, when is the last time somebody is actually executed in this country, put to death? Has anybody been put to death in Ohio?
It was in Texas.
Yeah. Well, I know Texas. They always frying people. But
yeah,
what about...
there hadn't been one for a while, but there was one last month, I believe.
Well, that's good. I mean, these people don't need to be sitting on death row for 30 years, you guys. They don't need to be there.
Don't you see that they fucking dropped the death penalty on the Boston Marathon bomber?
Yeah, Joker.
Yeah, I was reading something about that. But look
at
that.
He got vacated.
What was that guy's name? Timothy McVeigh. Man, you guys realize that guy went to trial and they executed that guy quick. I mean, they got rid of him real quick.
Appeals.
He denied his appeals. He just wanted to die and get it over with.
Yep, 2 years.
Well, I think I would do that. If I was in his shoes, which I hope I'm never, but I wouldn't want to sit there and fucking wait to be fucking murdered, would you?
You know what got him probably was the fact that there was kids in the building and a lot of them died. He probably didn't know there was any kids in the building.
Yeah, but look, Jimmy, I know he did a bad thing, but the prisons are full right now. Death row is full at all these prisons. Bad people, why are we letting them just sit there? Let's get rid of these people, man.
See, I believe in the death penalty, but it's got to be ironclad.
Right.
Now, what do you mean by that? Explain yourself.
He's got to have done it. You know what I mean?
You know what I mean?
He's
not
claiming innocence
testimony.
And everybody's saying you're guilty.
Well, with today's technology, you guys, I mean, if they like DNA and all that stuff, I mean, it's almost, well, I'm not going to say it's foolproof, but they're getting pretty damn good at figuring out who did what anymore.
I agree, but that's what I'm saying. But it can't be on eyewitness testimony because eyewitness testimony sucks.
It's the lousiest testimony you can get.
Well, there's another word for that. What is that? That's circumstantial evidence, right? Is that what it's called?
Well, circumstantial evidence is when you have small amounts of evidence that don't particularly point to the person by any one piece, but when all the pieces come together, it's
circumstantial.
The odds are so astronomical that it's not somebody else.
Just like Charles Manson. I think the guy, he only killed one of the guys. His little flower kids did the rest of the killings. But that guy sit there in prison since the 70s. And, you know, he just died, I don't know.
69.
Yeah, but that was because of the Supreme Court.
Well, they shouldn't have let him sit there. They should have fried his ass a long time before.
No, well, it's the California's another one that did.
It was because the Supreme Court declared the death penalty unconstitutional.
Oh,
the
wow.
Everyone on death row was given life sentences.
So,
and then each state decided which.
Oh, my God. I mean, I just can't see everybody sitting there. Do you know the guy made a lot? I don't think he was getting the money, but that Charles Manson, somebody made a lot of money from that guy. Somebody on the outside was making money from this guy.
You know who he babysat for?
Who's that?
Grandpa Munster.
Really?
Yep. He was their babysitter for like 3-4 years.
Grandpa was old in the 70s.
Now, he was in... He knew the
wasn't that old. He was in his 20s when he got arrested.
Just telling you, I heard him on Howard Stern.
Grandpa? I don't think so.
Didn't he
Unless
even
that guy was younger.
He knew the Beast Boys too or something like that, didn't he? I mean, he was
he was from California.
I the state of California, if you ask me, guys, I mean, there's probably a lot of good people out there, but that state sucks. I wouldn't live in that state for nothing.
You couldn't drag me there.
The state's beautiful with people.
Yes. Not all of them, but I mean, the most of them, the biggest part. I mean, it's just, It's like it's another country, you guys. And
it's like little Mexico in L.A. where they live, the Mexican parts there. It's, you know what I mean? It's not America.
I don't think it is. And I you know what? Everybody's always saying, oh, I hope Trump wins. Like Trump, which, I hope he wins California. He's the last person. Nah, you're never going to get it. So we might as well just block that off. We know the Democrats are going to get them, what, 50-some electoral votes out there. They got 55, something like that, maybe.
They got a few.
But what was the last Republican? Reagan to win that state? Was it Reagan?
No, Schwarzenegger.
No, he was governor. President.
Because he did.
It was Reagan because he won 49 states against Mondale.
I don't know.
He did run against Mondale.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, he ran against Carter the first time, and Mondale Ferraro, second.
The Geraldine Ferraro.
What was this?
Yeah.
Well, it was Carter was the first.
84.
Wait a minute. Carter was the first election, right?
Ran against them.
Carter was with Mondale in 76. Okay. Carter ran in 80, and then Mondale ran in 84.
Oh, okay. That was the first election I could vote in.
Bush Sr., he ran against Dukakis, didn't he?
He's the first Bush. Yep.
The first Bush. Then Clinton came along after Bush.
Yeah, and so did what's his name there? The guy that looked like a chicken.
Ross Perot.
Yeah, remember that when they had all three of them up? I thought that was a great debate with all three of them up there.
I liked the guy. I joined his campaign and everything.
You know, I think they should have three people up on stage. It makes it more interesting. Why just have two guys? I know I'm going to vote for Trump, but there should be allowed a third person up there, you know?
I'd like to see like a 4-5 party system.
I mean, let them debate the hell out of each other. I mean, you know what I mean? Let's hear from all of them. Let's see how they act.
Well, they used to do that sometimes when, what's his face? Oh, my God, he was a consumer advocate.
Ralph Nader.
Ralph Nader.
Oh, yeah, I remember that guy.
And he'd make a fool of himself.
It was always the third pin. Third party candidate in the 70s, 80s.
He destroyed the campaign.
Well, you guys know what destroyed Ross Perot, don't you?
What's that?
His fucking VP. Remember when that guy came on there to debate Dan Quayle and Al Gore? What was his name? General Saul? I don't know. He was a valid. Who am I? What am I doing here? And he didn't even know what he was doing. Stockdale. That was his name. Yeah. Stockdale.
He was a general.
Yes, man, but damn, he didn't need to be no vice president running, man. I mean, he didn't need to be a vice VP pick. Ross Perot messed up big time there.
Yeah, he had the fucking charm of a fucking glacier.
Oh, God, and Quayle and
hear
Gore.
Hear that sucking sound? That's all your jobs going to Mexico.
Quayle and Gore just left him standing there. I mean, he stood there like a buffoon. I mean, while they was hashing it out, you know what I mean? That was a good debate, though. I liked that debate.
I liked Ross Perot. I thought he was a real straight shooter. He was like a businessman. He was like the first Trump.
Yep. But he was a lunatic about a lot of things.
Well, that's it. The way he presented himself, nobody really knows the military and how you act around military.
He was for seizing everyone's guns.
No, he wasn't.
Yes, he was. No, that was one of the things the Republicans hated about him.
No, you're wrong. If he wanted to take guns away, I wouldn't have nothing to do with them.
That was one of his things. No? He didn't want people to have
I just remember his little head.
Style weapons and stuff.
He had a little head and big ears. I mean, that's what
big
I remember.
Big nose. Big nose, yeah.
Yeah. He looked like fucking trolls.
So, Jimmy and Paul, what do you think about Joe Biden picking Kamala Harris? Let's hear what you got to say about this.
I am so happy he did. She is a fucking albatross.
She ain't gonna get any black voters.
She's not black, you guys. She is not black.
Well, she is. She's Jamaican.
Well, her mother's from India. I mean...
That's so why she stayed a little darker, and the other one came from Jamaica, which they're usually light skin.
Yeah, but even Obama wasn't a full black man. I mean, that's what I'm saying. Even she said today that Joe Biden picked an African-American. No, he did not. She's biracial. Why do they say that, you guys?
Because they're pandering for votes.
Well, you know,
because...
Go ahead. I'm sorry, Jim. What if you were a black man or a black woman, and you've seen this old, almost 80-year-old white dude pick a black woman, just he says she's black, just to get your vote. You know what? That would offend me. I think I wouldn't like that.
Democrats don't think like that. They think of people in groups. And as long as you're in the right group, they're with you. Well, that's by race, I mean.
Well, Trump said she was a nasty lady, and I was doing some research on her. Man, when she was a prosecutor and a district attorney, I mean, she did a lot of bad things. She is a nasty lady. Look how she treated Brett Kavanaugh. Look how she treated William Barr. I mean, she is, you know what? If Joe happens to win this election, which I pray he doesn't, they're going to take him down, and she will be your president. I'm telling you.
Yeah, he won't be in office more than 6 months.
No, that's the plan, guys.
Yeah, I agree on that.
Would you agree on this? Now, I know on Facebook I'm not allowed to talk about COVID, but do you care if I talk about COVID on your show?
No. We're not on Facebook.
Here's my whole thing, guys. Look, it's been one thing after the other, right? And they knew they could not take this president down on his economy. He had this country great before COVID hit. Now, you guys got to think, it went from Russian collusion to fucking impeachment, COVID-19, civil unrest. And now COVID's coming back, and they're trying to shut us down before these elections, folks. We can't vote in person. That's what it's all about.
Right, because they want to use, they're going to cheat with the ballot.
The mail-in voting.
Yeah, they're going to cheat. He knows that.
And what's up? What the hell is up with Joe Biden with this Build Back Better bullshit?
I know it. You could get better than Trump.
Really? You?
And him?
Well, I mean, what if he does build back better? Hell, they're telling the people to burn the cities down. So what good is it going to do to build back better when they're just burning it down?
That's a good point. Yeah. That's a really good fucking point.
I'll tell you something else, Paul. Jimmy, think about this. Now, I've thought about this. If President Trump gets reelected, all right, he ain't allowed to run again. It'll be a second term. I guarantee you that November 4th, if he gets reelected, there will not be another protest because he will squash it in 1 second if there's another protest after he's reelected.
Oh, yeah, because presidents always bring their agenda to its fullest.
Absolutely. Yes, Paul, you got it. And Trump, he's going to hit them fuckers right where, I mean, he'll hit them hard in his second term. He won't be a nice guy. You know what I mean?
Right, because they can try to impeach him. They can try to sue him. It ain't going to work.
I think he's going to go after a lot of this worldwide pedophilia fucking shit.
Yes, I mean, he needs to, but you're right, you guys. He's going to be so, I'm looking for a word. I don't know what to say on the word, how he's going to be after he gets reelected. He's not, like I said, he's not going to be Mr. Nice Guy and try to pander to everybody.
Nah, he's going to be relentless.
Because what's he got to lose after he's reelected? He's got nothing to lose, you guys. They can't impeach him.
Now,
you
know what I'm saying? Look like idiots.
The fucking protesters out there.
Well, they had something to impeach him on. They'd impeach him.
And everybody right now, they're always asking me, why don't Trump stop these? Why don't he stop these looters and rioters? Well, you know what? He wants them. It ain't like he wants them. He's letting you see what these Democratic cities are in. He wants you to see how they're out. You know how they are. Like, you guys think about this lady, the mayor of Chicago, Lori Lightfoot. What the fuck is that thing?
She looks like something from another planet.
Fucking Beetlejuice.
Yeah, I know, but
my God, who would vote for somebody like that?
Chicago, they all did.
Wow. But look what's happening in Chicago right now, you guys.
Did you see the other night when they put up all the drawbridges?
Yes, I mean, there's nothing left of Chicago, folks. They destroyed that city. Now they're wanting Trump to bail them out. I wouldn't give them a damn penny.
And he won't.
Now they're saying, another thing, you guys, what do you think about this? Now everybody's saying since Trump signed those four executive orders, with that one where he deferred people's payroll taxes, everybody, he's going to take your Social Security. That's a fucking lie. That's a pure lie.
The Democrats have been using that tactic since before Reagan.
You're right, to scare the old people.
Because if you play any of the games with them, they'll vote against you.
And what do they listen to? Most of them watch CNN and all this other shit, and they listen to the news. They take that shit by heart, man.
I think less more not than before.
Because
the old people aren't so easy to fool no more because they've heard it 1,000 times.
And the news that's coming out is just ridiculous.
They always, yeah, he's going to take your Social Security. And another thing is, what the hell was I going to tell you? I forgot. I'm having a Joe Biden moment here.
Baby. I got two Jimmies.
Wow.
It goes but, that quick.
What do you guys think? Do you guys think they're going to try to kill our president? Because I know 4 days ago somebody took a shot outside the White House and they escorted Trump from that briefing. I think somebody's going to try to assassinate him.
I've never heard about a shot on him.
Well, we're getting closer to the election.
I wake up every day saying, all right, is this the day Trump gets shot?
I wouldn't somebody, put it past.
Oh, I know.
I wouldn't
so
put
angry.
It past the world leaders.
I'm really starting to worry about this. I wasn't up until this election. It's getting close. Somebody's going to take a pop shot at him, guys, and that would be horrible.
I mean, if they ever catch Harrison, right, he will be led into a basement, and he will talk because his rights will not exist.
What do you think would happen, though, if they kill our president? I mean, I'm not saying I love the man. I mean, but he's got a lot of support out here, you guys.
He's
the
best president ever that I can see.
Do you think that we would get out of here? Do you think that we would stand up and go crazy in this country?
Yes, absolutely.
I mean, they better not kill our president. That's all I'm saying. I wasn't around when Kennedy got shot. I wasn't around. Maybe you guys was. I wasn't.
Jimmy was. I wasn't.
Oh. Kennedy got shot. Yeah, I was in the first grade.
I mean, that was so fucked up right there. That whole ordeal was messed up, you know, with Oswald and that one guy that shot Oswald. I mean, that was stupid. It was all stupid, man.
Jack Ruby.
Jack Ruby, yes, you got
it. How the fuck did he get to walk up right up there?
That's a good question.
The bar owner, and I think it's the cop's bar.
Oh, that's right. I did see a thing on that. Yeah, they just thought, hey, it's Jack.
I mean, yeah, Ruby's place or something.
I mean, they actually had the cameras were rolling, and you saw that Ruby guy just walk right up and pow. I think he shot him in the gut.
Yeah, it must be, because that's what I thought. I said it was too high for the dick, but he must have got he went for the gut shot.
But you know what? It didn't look like a mortal wound. I think when they got him in an ambulance, him ambulance driver, I think they just muffed him on out, choked him, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Well, he was dying of cancer.
Was he?
Yes.
Who, Oswald?
No, Ruby.
Now, he stayed in prison for years, though, didn't he?
No.
No.
I don't know how long he did. I don't remember.
He died of cancer fairly quickly, I believe. You don't remember a big trial, do you?
No, I don't. They wanted to shut Oswald up, because you guys remember the day they got him, he did say he was a patsy. I don't know, you guys. I mean, that's been going on for years now. So what, 6 years?
Exactly how they said it.
What, now, tell me how they said it. Tell me your version.
Oswald did it. Oswald fired the shots.
But do you think he acted alone?
From the front building.
Did he act alone?
Yes. I believe he did.
You don't believe in the grassy note there?
No.
Or somebody.
There might have been a CIA giving the extra fucking backup in case he needed it.
But all the shots they can prove came from the same direction, basically.
Right, that's what I'm saying.
Oh, they've done that.
From the same building.
They've rerun that over and over them tests. Yeah, I know what. I've seen all the tests. I mean. But I don't know, there's just something weird. Like, it just happened that Zapruder, that, what is it, Zapruder?
Zapruder
film, yes, yeah, Zapruder film. And everybody's seen that, and it looks to me like he got shot from the front at the first shot, because he went back. I don't understand it. It is kind of confusing.
It's because of how high-velocity bullets work. When it hits you, it jerks you forward, and then your head snaps backwards. It's just because of the momentum of the bullet.
I guess it went through him so fast he went back. But you guys, I don't know if a lot of Americans know, but you know his fucking head came apart, man. I mean, his head came off, man.
His fucking brains were still on his fucking coat while they're swearing in fucking LBJ.
He was, yes, and he was dead way before they even got him to the hospital. You guys know that.
Oh, yeah, his brain was gone.
He might have still been bleeding. It just hadn't bled out yet, but yeah, he was gone.
There would have been no reviving him. I mean, there would have been.
He'd have been a vegetable if they did. Well, how are they going to put the brains together?
Imagine if they did, right? He could run as a Democrat today.
Well, you guys know, I mean, honestly, I don't believe this, but everybody right now, these QAnon people, I don't follow Q, but They all think that John F. Kennedy's going to come back. I mean, that's all I keep hearing.
Are you talking about Kennedy, QAnon?
QAnon, yeah, QAnon, Q Anonymous, whatever.
I don't
know what it is. A lot of people follow that.
Wow. She watches it 24/7.
What's it about, conspiracy?
It is conspiracy. You got to follow little tips, and I don't get into that crap. I don't buy it. I don't get into Q.
You'll love this too, Donald. My neighbor, right? She actually believes that everyone in Hollywood and politics and stuff are clones. They've all been executed by Trump, right? And they made clones, but they can age these clones, and they can take their memories and put it in the clones.
That's right up there with the flat Earth people, man. People still think the fucking Earth's flat. Come on, get real. We got satellites. We know the Earth's round.
We got pictures to prove it.
I mean, how could you sit there? I mean, there is, Jimmy and Paul. There's thousands of people that think this fucking planet's flat. Wow.
I watch this guy, Cyan Man Dan, on YouTube, and that's what he deals with a lot, flat earthers and shit, and he just rips these people.
Wow. They do need ripped. There's so much conspiracy, guys. I don't really get into conspiracy. The only thing I really believe in, maybe, is that one world order. I do believe in that, maybe.
Yeah, I do.
Because I think the Pope is in on that, too, because he's mentioned that a lot of times. I don't know what to say about this Pope.
Spanish dude?
Yeah, I don't know. Francis.
Francis, the fucking Skinner.
I know there was a German guy in there right before him. He resigned. Benedict, yeah. I mean, I grew up with Pope John Paul. That's the only Pope I remember as growing up. But, yeah, this guy, he's talked about this one world order crap, you guys.
Yeah, because... But that's what, like, the Rothschilds and all them people they want.
What it is the richest men around the planet. Not just the country. It's Bill Gates. It's Bill Gates that are all over the planet.
Yeah. They want a two-tier system.
Well,
the ultra-rich and the rulers, and then the impoverished peasants.
Well, if you had their money, though, like Bill Gates, I mean, he's got everything he wants. What more could you want but power? The only thing you can have is power, and he's already got some power. I mean, the only thing left is to conquer the world. You know what I mean? The world belongs to me. That's what they want. They want the world, you guys.
They're like Trump fucking Pinky in the Brain.
And Trump is the only one standing in their way. He's just a billionaire. He's a welfare bum to these guys. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Compared to these guys, he's a peon. But he's standing in their way of this. I do believe that.
Oh, well, there ain't too many billionaires. Trump's got 10 billion.
No, he doesn't.
No. He's lost money since he became president. He's the only president. Yeah. He's lost $3 billion since he became president. He's down to like $2 billion now.
$3 billion he's lost?
He's lost maybe over $3 billion. Now listen, you guys know most presidents go in the White House kind of broke, and most of them come out of there rich. Trump is going to be the only president in history that actually went in rich, and he's going to come out kind of broke. I mean, not real broke, but he's coming out with less than he had. So you tell me he's not a true president.
Yeah, a true patriot.
He loves his country. He don't even. You guys know he don't take his salary. Nobody even thinks about that stuff, man.
I don't look how much Obama made while he was president.
Yeah, I know. He was a millionaire by the time he came out.
He's worth like $100 million.
And Clintons, the Clintons are the same way.
Yeah, they said they came out of the presidency broke.
Shit.
They did.
Shit.
They got all their money from Saudi Arabia.
Well, and the Clinton Initiative.
When she was Secretary of State.
Initiative.
Yeah, that's what I mean. That's why she opened it up, because that's where they sent the money to.
Well, you guys know how old Jerry Nadler. Jerry Nadler always thinks that the Russia is colluding to get President Trump reelected. China. No. If China died, tell me how you guys feel. I think, if anything, China and Russia, they would want Joe Biden to win this presidency. They don't want Trump in there.
Of course they did.
China wants Biden, for sure.
For sure.
Yes, absolutely. Now, do you think Russia wants Trump? No, Trump's hard on all of them, you guys.
That's true.
They're meddling. Like back in 2016, that whole Russian collusion thing, they weren't trying to get Trump to win the election. They were trying to get Hillary to win the election.
Yeah, the Ukrainians.
Well, they were giving them our uranium, and they were sending plane loads of money to Iran. And people forget about that, you guys.
The Ukrainians have even admitted that they worked to get Hillary elected.
ask me this. Paul, you're really good on this stuff. Now, look, they impeached our president talking about this fucking Ukrainian shit. And Joe Biden, on a video, plain sit there and flat out admitted, you know, talking about his son getting money and firing the prosecutor over in Ukraine and that Burisma company. Now, why is that swept under the rug? Why is he even allowed to run for president?
Because it's only a crime if a Republican does it.
You're right. I believe that now, and I don't. It's crazy. The world's went nuts. You guys, are they going to? If they win the election, are they going to come hunting us down like dogs? Everybody voted for Trump. Is it going to be like the Planet of the Apes?
Jesus, I never even thought about that.
I mean,
up my game.
They said Kamala Harris once said that if Trump loses this election, they were going to hunt down every Trump supporter. They will not leave one stone unturned. So I don't know what they're going to turn this country into, you guys.
Well, then how about we hunt them down?
Well, that's what if Biden gets in, this is when the revolution starts.
I think a civil war. Yeah, revolution, civil war. Something's going to happen.
Something's going to happen. Like I said, we're all going to start either going out and killing all fucking Democrats, especially the politicians. You know what I mean? It's like, instead of having a real war, we're just going to go out and start sniping.
Well, we would win because, I mean, most conservatives own guns. Most Democrats don't own guns, you know, liberals. Most of them... Their skin is the consistency of a Kleenex, you know what I mean? They're real soft-skinned people, and they get their feelings hurt really easy.
Oh, shit, yeah. You want to trigger a liberal, just say anything.
Just say, I support Trump. Wear Trump hat. They hate you. You're a Nazi. You're a racist.
Yeah. Yeah. And that's another thing. Like, Tucker Carlson mispronounced fucking... Harrison, what's her name?
Kamala. Well, however the hell you say
Kamala.
It.
No, Karma, that's what it is.
All right, and then all right, I get
Lara
it.
At the end. But Tucker... Kamala.
I say Kamala. can say like some...
pronounced her name.
Yeah, he did.
And then fucking everyone jumped on him saying it was, you know, it was racist and misogynist.
Wait. We had a Democrat on the next night.
And then Joe Biden the next day did it.
Well, they didn't say anything about that, did they?
Nah.
No, they didn't.
Well, Joe Biden said a lot of crazy things, you guys. I've got so much shit on here. I've got these videos where you guys have heard the gaffes. That man's crazy. He don't need to be running for president. It's elderly abuse, man, what they're doing to that old guy.
And whenever he can't answer a question,
if Joe Biden gets in, I got come on, faith
man.
In mankind.
None. No, if he gets in there, something was rigged. Somebody cheated.
There's no enthusiasm for Joe Biden.
No.
Not zero.
You know, and they shut Trump's rallies down. They didn't want him to have rallies this year. Think about this whole timing of this virus. Think about the timing. Right before the election, really?
Oh, it's the most dangerous virus ever to strike mankind. Go fuck yourself.
See, that's why I'd like to come on this show because I can be me on here. You know what I mean? On Facebook, I'm restricted. I got to watch everything I say on Facebook because the community standards. You know what I mean? On here, I'm free to say anything. That's why I like this platform. I like it because I can be me.
Well, we'd love to have you back, Donald. You can have your own show and you can come on with us. Right. We'll come on your show.
Well, as fast as this freaking show is going, I can almost do an hour. I do now. Ask Jimmy. I go on live Facebook sometimes for 3 hours. Paul, I've got people calling in now on my live videos. They're calling in. I'm reading comments. I mean, we're having a great time on here. I had a black guy call me the other night. Seriously. And he was telling me how much he hated America. He hated our flag and... I let him talk, and I wanted people to see how racist this man was.
I watch your videos. Sometimes I don't go the whole distance.
Is this the one that was married to a white broad?
Who's that?
Jimmy Sanders.
It was your first 3 hour show there. You did. He was the last caller.
Marcus. I mean, his name was Marcus.
Yeah.
And he was married to a white chick.
Yeah.
But well, all white people are racist.
You could hear her talking in the background, couldn't you, Jimmy? And she was trying to tell him what to say. And, man, he really dug himself a hole. And he tried to pull me in a race debate, Paul.
Oh, Jesus.
I'm glad you listened. Thanks.
The only weapons they have. No magic.
Wow, man. I mean, you heard it. He was talking about Africa, and I said, well, listen, man. I said, I'm not trying to be mean or nothing, but this is a free country now. You can move your ass right back to Africa. And he didn't want to answer that question. Why don't you move to Africa?
If it's so fucking great.
Yeah. Well, I've been there.
Have you been to that continent, Jimmy?
No. You're saying that's what the guy said, right?
Yeah, he's been there and he owns property or something. I'm like, well, fucking move there. I didn't say that in them words, but...
Yeah, you know, I know. You did say, well, why don't you move to Africa?
Yeah, I said, if you don't like this country, move to Africa. And he said, yo, that flag, y'all care about that flag. That flag don't mean shit. I said, buddy, that flag represents every man who died in every war fighting for your damn freedom, buddy. I didn't say it that way, but kind of like that, Jimmy.
Yeah, I love people that just... fucking sit and complain about this country and do nothing to help.
Nothing.
Look at Black Lives Matter. Name one black family that they've helped out.
They got millions, almost $1 billion in contributions. And do you think Josh Floyd got any out of that?
Nothing. And even if he did, the average black person's not getting anything out of it.
Why don't they protest for all the black-on-black crimes, all the little kids that gets killed by blacks? They're killing themselves, but that don't matter. Only if a white man kills a black man, then it's a crime to them. Then it's holy hell.
Or it's a cop. It doesn't matter if it's a black cop.
Yeah, it don't even matter. Hell, then they've even killed a couple cops during these riots and looting. They've killed cops, and nobody seems to care that they're out here killing cops.
Well, the shit's going to hit the fan. Oh, they're gonna be fucking sorry.
You know what?
Black Lives Matter is losing people. You know, like support from people that aren't in it. Say,
well, Paul, you remember that white couple? I can't think of their damn name. They pulled their guns out on all those protesters. You know, they're going to try to prosecute them people.
Yeah, the state's attorney said, no, it's not happening.
Yeah, that's stupid. That's so stupid. It's like right now, the whole country is pandering to black people. Why? I mean, because they're out here. Why don't you? Well, some of them are white. So a lot of these people are white that's out here. But you don't see white people doing that kind of stuff. We don't act like that. And another thing, our prison systems. You know, the population of our country is only 13% black. But our prison population is almost 90% black. I can't explain that. That's what I asked that guy the other night, Marcus. He didn't want to talk about that neither.
Of course, because it's not convenient.
No, he was a pure racist. and he admitted, he sat there and said that we have white privilege. I said, buddy, I worked hard my whole life. Don't you ever tell me I had white privilege. I starved growing up, buddy.
Yeah, white. White I don't know privilege. A lot, but I worked for what I got.
Well, have you ever had white privilege, Paul?
Oh, yeah.
And I know Jimmy sure ain't had no white privilege.
Nah. Jimmy probably had less privilege than all of us.
That just burns me up when I hear that white privilege shit. That goes through me so bad.
It's just another fucking way to try to shut you up. Because then they say, well, you're using your white privilege. Your voice isn't valid.
But you know, Paul, I think there is a lot of black people out there. They're waking up. They're waking up. And I think President Trump, as a Republican, he's got more support from the blacks than any other president Republican has.
Oh, they're saying he might get up to 40%
of the black people. Oh, man. Whether they're waking up, I mean, a lot of them don't approve of what they're out here doing in the streets. They don't like it burning down their own businesses and stuff, you know?
Exactly. Think of it this way. Even if you were on the fence about Black Lives Matter and stuff, right? And you lived in Minneapolis, say, and the only supermarket that you could get to got burned down.
Burned down or looted? Yeah, I mean,
both.
And there's old people. I mean, that's the only, they don't have cars. They walk to these little markets, and what do? They hurt their aunts, their grandmas. That's all they did.
And now they think, well, I tried it that way. That was the result. I'm going the exact opposite way.
Well, here's what I was saying.
Jimmy, that guy on Fox, the black dude.
Leo Terrell.
Juan Williams?
No, Leo Terrell.
lifelong Democrat and hardcore. And
he's an attorney.
Yeah, and he was a lunatic about being a leftist. He's voting for Trump.
Really?
Yep. Matter of fact, Hannity had him on last night.
Trump was on the phone.
Trump was on the phone with him. And he's like, I got your back, brother. And Trump's laughing. And they just have... And Hannity's got a smile on his face. Fucking air to air. It was beautiful.
I didn't get to see it. I wish I'd got to see that. What was that black guy's name that ran for president? Herman Cain. Jimmy, do you remember that Marcus guy talking to me? You remember what he said Herman Cain was? He said he called Herman Cain a coon. He called that man a coon. Right. And I'm like, what does that mean? What do you mean by coon?
He was cooning around.
Yeah, he said that. That means he's like an Uncle Tom, I guess. You know what I mean?
Yeah, when he's with black people, he's black. And when he's with white people, he's...
He's white or black. Yeah. But, man, come on, dude. I mean... Black people, some of them, not all of them, they don't make sense, man. And this reparations, I never owned a freaking slave.
Neither of these people's, the houses and businesses they're breaking into for reparations. Everything's going to be reparations now.
Well, they're getting reparations. Anybody who doesn't want to work,
will give it to them.
Well, you know why? Do you know why the Democratic Party is all for welfare? They want to keep people on the system. They want people to need the government. They want people dependent upon the government. That way they control them people.
That's where they think they can stay in office forever, is because they're going to have the people, will of the people. That's why they want the illegals to be legal. So you know what? Democrats.
They want to keep them dumb, too, Paul, Jimmy. They want to keep them dumb.
Really? Well, they want to keep the public in general dumb. The public school systems are...
That's why our schools are fucked right now. Our schools are fucked, you guys.
We're never going to change the country if we don't change the kids.
That's it, but our schools... Look what our schools are teaching in school right now.
We need somebody, a secretary, to stop all that shit.
They the teachers' unions... want to do televised schooling,
They need to go back to school. Wait a
minute. It gets better. They want it so the parents can't be in the room while they're doing the schooling.
Why? Because they may intervene?
No, because they don't want to hear the fucking brainwashing.
Yeah, exactly.
That's what I meant. You know, if I heard that, and then I'd be like, hold on here. You didn't tell my kids something like that, you know?
Exactly.
Well, look, Paul, what is it? I don't remember the month. I think it may be February. Black History Month. Yeah. Every child in this country has to learn about blacks. Now, why is it, if you was black, if you did something, you should already be in the history books. We don't need a separate history.
Yeah, I know it.
This is America.
They didn't teach any black history.
There
were some people that should have been taught.
They don't want equal treatment under the law. They want special treatment under the law.
Special treatment. You got it, Jimmy. And welfare right now, that is reparations, if you ask me. And how do we know? How do we know they're not giving black people more than they are poor white people? We don't know that.
Obama was giving black people $50,000 a year, and all they had to do was have a house plant in their apartment. And they were getting money from
some farmer's bill.
Yeah, they were getting agriculture. $50,000 a year for fucking having a pot.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
They already got their reparations. They're never going to be satisfied. They're going to keep whining and whining.
Dude, they're living better than anybody else in the country. In the world. Now, what would have happened if our ancestors, our forefathers, hadn't brought them over here? They'd be still living over here, starving to death. They ought to be glad that they came over here. And like the movie Roots, I gotta tell you right now, movies are movies. That movie Roots, they showed you all the bad things about slavery. But you guys know that most of them slave owners treated their slaves pretty damn good.
Oh, they did. I know.
Well, they don't tell you that. Times were tough for the average person.
For the average person, times were tough.
Yeah. So the average person might be going through, like, being really hungry when a slave wasn't. But they were slaves. All right, come on, let's face it.
But they never tell you that. They never tell you that. And you guys may not believe me, but back in those days, there were black rich men that owned black slaves.
Oh, yeah.
They brought them over.
That's true. That's true.
And who hunted them down? Their own people. Their own people hunted them down and sold them to the Spaniards, the English, and it was their own people, and it wasn't white people going through them jungles.
Well, no, they were usually prisoners of war or something like that.
I tell you what, I'm glad we're not on Facebook. They done had us banned right now, I tell you. But we're not racist. I'm not a racist guy. I'm really not. I don't. It's
discussing race does not make you racist.
Yeah, I know.
Thank you.
It's done reasonably. Because, let's face it, black people 200 years ago had it shitty. And they had it shitty right in through the 50s and stuff.
Yeah.
They did.
During right up to the Civil Rights Movement.
But we rectified that.
In the 60s.
By the matter of fact, by the Republicans.
Right.
Well, you know what? Who the fuck freed them? Did they forget it was a Republican, Lincoln? The black guy down the night said that Lincoln was not a Republican. I said, buddy, you don't even know fucking history. You don't even know your history. He was the first Republican.
Yep, the party was formed as an anti-slavery party.
Oh my God, these people, why don't they educate them? If they would get educated,
like I
they
said,
would understand.
They don't educate them, they indoctrinate them. They don't tell them the real history. They make up this shit about, especially with Columbus. Because it came and they got diseases. That wasn't his fault. He didn't know he was taking diseases.
He wasn't a nice guy. He really wasn't.
Well, you know what? For 500 years, everybody looked at him as a hero. And you know, in Ohio, our capital is Columbus, and they've been taking down every damn Christopher Columbus statue. And I think that's wrong. Leave our history alone. That's what Hitler did.
That's wrong, too. That's a statue, right? Do you like him? Okay. Do you hate him? Okay. It's a fucking statue.
Right.
Walk away.
Walk away. But, you know, one person can bring it up to the city manager or whatever, and why don't they put that shit to a vote? Let the people decide if that statue gets removed. You know, let the people, not just the little city council members.
You know why? Because they're fucking sniveling cowards. And they know the lunatics are going to rip it down anyways.
Well, yeah. Well, they was trying to rip down the statue of Andrew Jackson there in D.C., and he was a damn Democrat. Did they even realize that?
They don't care. They don't care.
Oh, God.
All they care about is anarchy.
There you go. I believe that. And I think they was even trying to desecrate some parts of Arlington National Cemetery.
Yeah.
They don't care.
Some group went after a Frederick Douglass statue.
Yeah, I know. He's black.
Wow. What about Aunt Jemima, you guys?
Uncle Tom.
Yeah, Aunt Jemima. Aunt Jemima's gone. Uncle Ben's is gone.
You guys
they
know
took the Indian woman off of Land O'Lakes.
Yes. You know that Aunt Jemima, I forget her name, her last name's Green, but you know she was the first African-American model, and she loved doing that. She loved being Aunt Jemima. And they took it away? Really?
Her great-grandson, I believe it was, is pissed.
I don't blame him. I mean, who are they to decide that was racist? And I went out and got me some Aunt Jemima syrup and some batter, and I ate it. And if that's racism, it sure tastes pretty good, guys.
Yeah. Oh, as a matter of fact, my wife said the next time she goes out, she's going to get a couple of bottles.
You better get it before it's gone.
Just to keep them.
What,
hey,
Aunt Jemima?
Yeah. The Mrs. Butterworths.
Oh, yeah.
Because
Mrs. Butterworths. Wait a minute. Mrs. Butterworths, she's white. Miss Butterworth's white.
No,
she isn't.
Oh, look it up. Google it right now. Mrs. Butterworth, they did some research. She is a white woman. She just looks black because of the syrup. Hey, I wouldn't lie. I swear to God, you guys, I looked it up. But listen, hey, you guys, it's a real small clip of Robin Williams. Now, Robin Williams has been dead for a while. It's 28 seconds. Do you guys mind if I play it?
No, please do.
Now, he's on here talking about Joe Biden, but it's real short, okay? And this is back in 2008, 2009. Listen to what he says. Here it goes.
But we still have great comedy out there. There's always rambling Joe Biden. Joe says shit that even people with Tourette's go, no. No. What is going on? Joe is like your uncle who's got a new drug and hasn't got the dosage right. Proud to work with Barack America. He's not a superhero, you idiot. Come here. PR was on television. There was no TV back then. Come here, Joe. Sit down.
I mean, that, I mean, Robin Williams even had it right back in those days, guys. That was it. That's all I had. It was just 28 seconds. Yeah,
that's because he ran when Obama ran in 2008. Biden did, too. So when he lost, Joe picked him for vice president.
You know, I never knew Robin Williams cussed like that.
Consolation prize.
Oh, he always cussed.
I didn't know. I mean, he seemed like such a nice guy on his movies, but I didn't know he cussed like that.
Well, yeah, that's why he made it in TV. He didn't.
Wow, man.
I thought he was great stand-up.
He was stand-up. Stand-up.
Well, I think he was better stand-up than an actor. I like him better.
I think the exact opposite.
I think he's a better drama actor than a comedian actor.
Well, he has made a few movies where he wasn't acting goofy, yeah. You know. I didn't like him as Mork. I didn't like that role.
Yeah, I didn't either.
Nothing better. Yeah. It was really stupid, Mork, for Mork. I don't know.
But he had his mentor, Jonathan Winters, on a few episodes.
Who I also could not stand.
I didn't think he was that funny either.
See, I would ask you guys a quiz, but I know Paul get it. Paul's like a big buff on old shows and stuff, but I'll ask you guys anyway. Where did this show, Mork and Mindy, originate from?
Happy Days.
There you go. You got it, because he had a fight with Fonzie, remember?
Yeah, his finger against Fonzie's thumb.
Yes, yes. Oh, I knew you'd get that one. I knew you'd get it. One more quiz, you guys, for both of you. And I know you're going to get it. And a lot of people don't know this. It's Republicans. What does the letter OP stand for?
Grand Old Party.
You damn it. Damn it, Paul. Can't get you on nothing.
Well, we just did that the other night or something, didn't we?
Did we?
Yeah.
I don't remember that.
I think I was listening to you.
You was listening to me? I quizzed I quizzed the people on Facebook. And nobody answered. I was like, grand old party.
I didn't know it until you told me.
Do you guys know where the donkey slogan came for the Democratic Party?
Yeah, Andrew Jackson.
Yes, yes, yes.
They used to call him a donkey's jackass. Ass. A
jackass. That's yeah. Right. You got him.
So he ran as a Democrat, and he made that the logo.
Man, you guys are, I'll tell you what, I can't get nothing over on you guys. I mean, you guys, like, know history really good, man.
Back then you didn't have Google. You know what I mean?
So no, you had to go get a book.
Easy about it.
You had to go get a book and actually look something up. I mean, think about when we were kids. Even when I was a kid, we didn't have no damn computers. I mean, we were lucky to even have a library card, you know?
Yeah, we had
a
set of encyclopedias.
There you go. That was your computer. Yes.
That's who you look shit up for.
A through Z. I remember our encyclopedias, and boy, did we use them a lot, man.
And I remember my father kind of bitching about it because it was really expensive back then. And my mother's like, no. These kids are going to have a fucking set of encyclopedias.
Well, you remember the salesman, they would come around and try to sell everybody encyclopedias back in those days. Mm-hmm. Oh, God, they got on your nerves, man.
Oh, I did that for a while.
Oh, you sold encyclopedias?
Yeah. It was less than a month.
Did you sell Kirby vacuums, too, Jimmy?
No,
Kirby?
Yes, I did.
No,
God.
Full of brushes.
Oh, God. Jimmy
was the full of brush man.
Oh, God. He sold encyclopedias and Kirby vacuums.
They could have shut the door. He put his 70s. Foot in there.
Wow.
Excuse me, ma'am. I just need to talk to you for a moment. She's trying to slam the door. You got your foot in there.
Jimmy, you had to be at Woodstock. I know you had to be there, wasn't you?
No, I was only 13.
Shit, I bet you wish you was there, don't you?
Oh, absolutely. When they were leaving the park, all the brothers and stuff,
What year did Woodstock happen, you guys?
1969.
Well, I can't get nothing on that. It was the year I was born. I was
August 13th, I think it started back then.
I was 4.
I was 7 days old. 7 days old. 6 days. I was born 13. On the 7th.
You might have even been cute then.
Actually, I was 12 because I would have been 13 August 19th.
Well, Donald probably looked like a baby like he does now. Like
I had a big head. I was born with... Hey, guys, I got two teeth left, and one of them's killing me right now. I got to have it pulled, but I was born with a big head, man. I mean, I've always had a big head my whole life.
I'm sure your mom was thrilled about that.
Oh, God, I bet it about killed her coming out of her. But, I mean, I was small, but my head was big. And my mom always said it, because I always said, Mom, my head's big. And I'd complain about it, but my body finally got caught up with my head, you know, when I turned 20. But I did. I had a big head. I couldn't even find a hat to fit me. Growing up, I couldn't even find a hat. You guys, it was horrible. And I was made fun of. Here comes Big Head Don. Big Head Don.
All his hats are stretched out.
Oh, God. I'd have to keep them hey, you snap them together. I'd have to unsnap them and just squeeze a hat over my head.
Oh, that's fucking great.
Couldn't put a Halloween mask on. That wasn't none big enough to fit my big head when I was a kid.
Like, what's his face? Rocky from Mask.
Yeah. Oh, God. Bro, that's awful. That's awful, man. The share. Rocky. He was going to travel Europe. That was my dream. That was, I didn't even travel this
for a show. Going free with Rocky.
You're making fun of my name, man. Go to hell, Paul.
It's a horrible name for a show.
Well, come on. All right, we got a few minutes left. Come on. What do you think would be a good name for a political show?
Oh, Jesus.
I can't say pot talk, politically no, sensitive talk.
No,
come on, you guys, help me out. Help me out. We got a minute. Come on, help me out. I thought Born Free sounded cool, man. Born Free.
Yeah, you could play that gay song from the movie.
What?
You could Born Free, that fucking stupid lion movie from the 70s.
What was that movie?
That's the first thing I think of when I heard that.
Didn't she die in the movie?
I don't know.
I don't remember that movie. I remember.
I have a penis. Why would I watch that movie?
It's about lions. I like them.
Yeah.
Paul, you got me to go and look up an old movie here a year or two ago, because I liked that movie called I Am Legend. I went back. You told me about the Omega Man. Omega Man. And man, I liked it better than I did the new movie.
I was young. I was foolish. I was angry. I was fun. I was charming. I was lucky. Tell me how.